Welcome to Naresai Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In this video, I'm going to talk about what is garbage collection in Java. What is garbage collection in Java? Who will support for that? And what type of thread will support for us to clean, to doing the process of garbage collection? So that type of interesting points we'll see in this video. Just focus on it. So what is garbage collection? Very simple. The process of cleaning, unused memory by calling finalize method. The process of cleaning unused memory by calling finalized method by garbage collector is called garbage collection. The process of cleaning unused memory by calling finalized method and by calling by whom? Garbage collector is called garbage collection. So cleaning unused memory. See, basically data has been classified into two types. One is static data, another one is what? Non-static data. By defaultly, JVM will provide the memory for what type of data? Static data. But not for non-static data. By default, JVM will provide memory for static data. By default, JVM won't provide memory for non-static data. Then if JVM not providing memory for non-static data, what programmer is going to do? Programmer make a request to whom? JVM. About what? Memory. By using what? By using object creation. So by defaultly, see, in entire Java language, for both static and non-static, who will provide the memory? JVM only. But JVM by defaultly provide the memory for what? Static data, but not for non-static data. So when JVM is providing the memory for non-static data, once a programmer asking to the JVM about memory by using what? Object creation. So that means to provide the memory for non-static data, programmer responsibility. Programmer should provide, programmer should shows responsibility, to provide memory for non-static data. Programmer should shows, gives responsibility for providing memory for non-static data. How? Generally, way of object creation, new class name. Yes. So while creating an object, JVM will provide the memory for non-static data. So memory allocation is taken care by whom? Programmer. So in memory allocation, again, two types of memory allocations. One is used memory. Another one is unused memory. One is used memory, another one is what here? Unused memory. So what is used memory? A memory which is going to use multiple times, that is called used memory. What is that used memory? A memory which is going to use multiple times is called used memory. Then how to develop this used memory? Class name, reference equal to new class name. So whenever we writing like this, by seeing this statement, JVM will provide what here? Memory. That memory is pointed by what? Reference. For example, there is a class A, and there is some data like int A equal to what? 111. Int B equal to what? 222. And public static void main. So both are non-static data. Is JVM provide the memory? No. We should go for what? Object creation. How? A OVJ equal to new A. Now in this particular time, what happened, guys? Very simple. JVM will provide some memory. That memory having what here? One identification number like 1010. That identification number like what? 1010. Clear or not? Now new A pointing to 1010. Okay, and this is the memory. Now in this memory, what type of data do we have? Non-static variable A, 0, first letter replaced with 111. Letter B, 0, replaced with what here? 222. So non-static loading phase, 0. In the non-static initialization phase, 111. Like this B also. Clear or not? Now I want to retrieve the 111 and 222. 111 and 222. System.out.println obj.a. So how many times I am communicating with the 1010? One time. And again, if I am writing like a system.out.println obj.a, how many times I am communicating? Two times. And if I am writing like a system.out.println obj.b, again how many times I am communicating? Three times. So a memory which is going to be used by the programmer multiple times, that memory we can call as what? Used memory. Garbage collector never touch what here? Used memory. Garbage collector never cleaning what here? Unused memory. Then what type of memory is going to clean? So garbage collector never touched used memory, only garbage collector cleaning unused memory. How to develop unused memory? Very simple. What is unused memory? First, what is unused memory? What is unused memory? A memory which is used by the whom? Programmer only one time is called what here? Unused memory. How to develop that unused memory? New class name, open and close parenthesis. Now system.out.println new a.a. Then in this particular time, what happened, guys? New a will provide what here? Memory. In that memory, what we have? 111 and 222. Assume this memory is what here? 2020. Memory is what here? 2020. Now in this memory, what we have? In this memory, what we have? A value 0 replaced with 111 and B value 0 replaced with 222. So new A means year 2020. New A means year what year? 2020. 2020 dot A, nothing but 111 printed. Now how can we communicating with the 2020 again? We can't. Only for assumption purpose I am taking 2020. Can we able to directly find out that one? No. If you are writing like a system.out.println new a dot b, what you feel like? Do you think is that new a again pointing to 2020? No. We will get one more memory. What is that one more memory? Assume 3030. Assume what is that? 3030. Now in that memory location, A value 0 initially, letter 111, and B value 0, letter replaced with what? 222. Letter replaced with what here? 222. Now unreferenced memory, we are always communicating with the unreferenced memory or anonymous memory or unused memory. How many times? Only one time. So this type of memory are cleaning by garbage collector. What is that? Garbage collector. The process of cleaning unused memory by calling finalize method by garbage collector is called garbage collection. If the garbage collector not cleaning the memory, what happens, sir? If you are keep on using, allocating the memory by the JVM with the support of main thread, what happens? Up to some instance, our memory will be filled. Once our memory will be filled, we can't do any other operations. If we are unable to do other operations, definitely our application is going to hang. To avoiding that problem, whatever the unused memory we have in our application, what are the unnecessary memory which is available in our application, that we are going to clean with the support of what? Garbage collector. So garbage collector is one thread. JVM using one thread like garbage collector to clean, thread like garbage collector. JVM uses one daemon thread like garbage collector. JVM uses one low priority thread like garbage collector to clean unused memory. This process we can call as what? Garbage collection. Now, what type of algorithm is using by the garbage collector? The algorithm name is what here? Mark and sweep. First, it will recognize whether the memory is used or unused. That we can call as marking. It will marking the memory as an unused. After that, it will cleaning. To clean this memory internally using mark and sweep algorithms, and internally again it will calling what here? Finalize method. So this is the process of what here? Garbage collection. I hope you enjoy this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.